a brief summary of my previous two videos about my RAM upgrade journey. In May, I ordered a Crucial Ballistix Max DDR4 for 1032GB kit from Amazon for €190, but I never received it because it was actually EOL. So, last month I searched for a suitable alternative and found this one. Kingston Fury Renegade 3600 megabits per second 32GB kit for €150. Now that I've installed it, does it perform better or worse than my ex-Ballistix Elite 3600 megabits per second 16GB kit? Before answering this question, let's compare their respective specs. While the Crucial DIMMs are single-ranked and equipped with Micron RevE, the Kingston ones are dual-ranked and equipped with SK Hynix DJR. Based on the XMP, the former has 9 tighter and 1 looser timings than the latter. Now, to find a response to that query, I tested the two kits 10 times in each of 6 benchmarks. ADA 64 read, write, copy and latency, Cinebench R23 multithreaded, and Unigine Superposition 180p Extreme. These are all the results with their mandatory descriptive statistics. Unintelligible, right? Therefore, let's translate them into classical charts to focus our attention on the means. As you can see here, whereas there is a tie in write bandwidth due to the design of Ryzen processors with a single CCD, Kingston seemingly loses in read and latency, but wins in copy, Cinebench and superposition. However, is the difference among each pair of means really significant? One way to know for sure is to conduct an inferential statistical analysis called independent t-test on all 5 of them. Well, 4, because I cannot run it on constant data, such as latencies. Still, they seem to be different enough, don't they? Anyway, before proceeding with the actual analysis, I must check that its assumptions are satisfied. This is true for all but the first pair, whose variances are not homogeneous. Hence, I have to execute a mildly diverse independent t-test on it, Welch's. And here are the full results. As RStudio returns a p-value less than or equal to 0.01 in both ADA64 tests, but not in Cinebench and Superposition, this implies that the difference between means is statistically significant only in the first two. In simpler terms, while the average read bandwidth of the Kingston kit is significantly lower than that of the Crucial one, the opposite is true for copy bandwidth. On the contrary, even if Hynix DJR also seems to be winning in Cinebench and Superposition, technically its performance gains are not significant. Basically, Crucial triumphs twice, Kingston once, and they draw all the other 3 times. So, how do I like my new RAM? Enough. Its success in the copy test, due to being dual rank, is much appreciated because it best reflects the workload of a typical application. I would have liked a lower latency though. Would I be able to achieve that of my Elite kit if I fine-tuned the timings without touching frequency and voltages? We will see. Meanwhile, another Crucial Ballistix Max 32GB kit reappeared on Amazon, so I've ordered it again. Will I get it this time? Most likely, no. But a dreamer must keep on dreaming. Fare you well for now.